So the piece is called Rectify, The Mother's Perspective. As these once, sometimes twice a week visits have stretched through the months, and now a whole year has passed, we settle into our 1 hour of non-stop talking. There's 6 words in Mi'kmaq that best describe our conversations. El to get, which is to weave, and telemati, to tell. Over time, we have come to embrace our definition of what family means and what it means to struggle to understand the impact of what going to war with yourself looks like. He has come to know that my obligation is to see him walk to himself. Every visit, I try so hard to not become hypnotized by that sterile institutional glass room. Sometimes it's hard not to think of the gloom and the darkness, the inhumanity he speaks of, and those soul-robbing people that I see. My concerns of his behavior and that train wreck that I saw coming, I had so little ability to derail. I see the polarization of extremes every time I enter that glass room, and I sit on that cold, hard, round stool. Some visits I hear the labels, the intel that they believe is him. Do they know that those tattoos he chose with such great care? They all have words for those tattoos. I keep my observations of the evident systemic discrimination to myself, and all I say is that the Gladue principle exists for a reason. We share how easy it is for people to see the images, the mass media feeds, and how easy it becomes for them to believe that those images are him. I see it so very humanly differently. I know the tragedies that those images have imposed on this one human being. I ask him, what does accountability mean to you? To rectify, to redeem, to restore justice, and how do you mend this sorrow? I know that he is blessed, and I know that he will emerge enlightened by his experience of what compassion, love, kindness he is capable of, and be prepared to live it out, yet remaining intolerant of this unjust time and the cage that they have put him in.
There are 2 visits that stand out. The first visit, she brought him, my brother. The grief and sadness clung to the glass like ice fog or some Stephen King movie. His words haunted me. Oh, I just didn't want to see you here like this. He rumbled on, blunt, loving, strong, hard, kind, angry, questioning, sad, and grief-stricken words. My face tightened, and I felt so disconnected from them. My only visitors in months. She put her hands up to the glass, filled with tears. All she said was, I love you. And now you understand the meaning of a mother's unconditional love. I told her, Mom, I'm at peace with however long this is going to take. I could tell all she felt was a desire to see this address restored of justice. Her thoughts she shared in short, calm bursts. My only concern now is how you keep your dignity, pride, and self-respect despite your current environment. She then decided to tell how the elder Kokum came to her in the night in a dream. Your Kokum pounded her staff in the ground and told me, that son, that one, he's in big trouble. Now go to him. It was hard to believe, but I know Mom is not crazy. I finally say to her, Mom, that's like me trying to understand aliens, really. Well, that is how it is. Embrace your culture. I'm now the holder of your eagle's feather. You won't be here forever. You will come home. You're beautiful. You're Métis. You're Mi'kmaq. This reminded me that things happen for a reason, and we don't know why, and it's not up to us to question. Every week, she leaves me a book, many on the topic of addictions, or from her favorite authors with hidden messages written by friends, usually on page 13. She asked me what I miss. Funny, my answer was sushi. Our limited conversations would always prove to be rich. I speak of the constant, everyday struggle to keep my composure. We have spoken of our shadows and how I rationalize all my past behaviors. One thing was for sure, this had to happen. I don't have another relapse in me. I understand that her hearing those words brings her great comfort. I know how grateful she is that I live and hadn't died. I had to observe the kind of environment I am in now. It is hard time with little to do. My only programming is the book she leaves and the very seldom game of basketball. Life is a series of choices, and we deal with those repercussions from them, sometimes the hard way. I know as much as she does that if I end up here again, I am in no way willing to deal with the repercussions that would bring. Realistically, I had no previous goals, no sense of direction when I was out there alone with my shadow. Even if I'm in prison, no amount of euphoria is worth what I've gained here. What was missing? I was missing something that I'm essentially hollow without. I was so out of touch. I've never felt better with the help of some sort of drug. Is this what it could have always been like sober?